couldn't have been me. See the direction sparkle for fruits. A noisy neighbor, an angry boyfriend. I'll never know, I wasn't home. I peer inside for a clue. No, I can't see. I reel, blind, like a film left out in the sun. But it's too late, my retinas already scorched with a permanent copy of the New York City. It's just a little wall, and it wasn't too bright, it was too deep, stretching forever into everything. A whole lot of different choices. I realize now that I wasn't looking in, I was looking out, and he, on the other side, was looking in. But he wasn't looking at me. Confused, I frantically glanced at my surroundings. But my burning eyes can no longer see color. Are there others in this room? Are they talking? Or are they simply bones on flat pieces of paper? The sound of print is growing, playing tricks on my fingers. The room begins to breathe, closing in on me. The air I feel dissipates before it reaches my lungs. I panic, there must be a way out. It's right there, it's right there. Swallowing my fingers, I brandish my head. Get out of my head, get out of my head. 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 Get out of my head, 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 get out of my head. Get out of my head before I show you how much I love you. Get out of my head before I finish writing this poem. But a poem is never actually finished. It just stops moving. But a poem is never actually finished. It just stops moving.